Hello and welcome to FX Bootcamp London. My name is Christian Stevens. Today is Thursday, February 4th, 2010. This is your daily London session video, a review of just a little bit of what we did today in the live London session class at fxbootcamp.com. Let me first remind you that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. We are not an alert service. Myself nor any of the other currency coaches will ever make any direct trade recommendations during the course of a session. Be mindful, please, that trading under leverage is always risky business, particularly as a novice trader. In Forex, using excessive leverage may occasionally work for you, but unfortunately, more times than not, it will work against you. So please do not trade real money until you have a proven track record of success on a free broker demonstration account. One more thing before we get started, whether you're watching this video on YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, or our blog at FX Street, I'd like to ask if you could please leave a comment when you're done watching, even if it's just a hello, thanks, we appreciate your feedback, anything's fine. Appreciate any feedback that you might give us. Well, the theme here has been weak pound for a while, and today was no exception. I'm going to focus real quick on, because as I'm making this video, the British news announcement's coming out soon, and I want to be part of that. The British pound dollar, is it two-hour chart from yesterday, had come off support resistance here at 160.68, the previous lows back here yesterday, and bounced fairly smartly back down to the 15 area, and has since tonight during the London session, you know, continued all the way down to 5800 before this rate announcement. But the pound yen and the yens in general have been sort of bottlenecked. This was the pound yen 2-hour chart here prior to today, and we had a little bit of a 45.20 zone trap going down to the 44.5 zone here. And right as we were opening the London session, we broke that. We were starting to break that trap, and this video is how we played that short and got short the pound yen pretty much right as the London market opened. If you look here at a pound yen, in the middle here you have a bounce earlier in the day off the weekly central pivot point, followed up by a daily central pivot point bounce around 44.70, and that's, you know, where we find ourselves. And when we're looking at a 15-minute chart zoomed out, this is kind of that little trap I was just showing you. You've got a series of lower highs, really, really weak, but also of higher lows, so you can see that some sort of a breakout is looking kind of imminent, but you know, you don't want to jump the gun when you're in any sort of an apex. So we're waiting for a breakout. In the very next candle, we get that. And it wasn't just the pound yen. We were getting a lower high developing on the dollar yen hourly, as well as the other yens looking very similar, but the pound being bearish seemed to be going at a little bit stronger clip. So once we saw this break, that's when it was time to try to plan an entry to wiggle into this trade, okay? And that took us down to about 44.30 or so. And then the very next candle, what happens is it actually took us to about, in this candle, to about 20, straight to 20. But this pullback here is what we're going to play. So what I'm showing on the 15-minute chart, I want to go to a 1-minute chart and show you how we played this entry, okay? Here's that break of that 40s area, right when we broke through here. This is the break candle, and this is the new 15-minute candle portion. So basically, that's the initial move, and we just take a fib study from the bottom of this to the top of the swing, even on a 1-minute basis, and just essentially look for, if I zoom in a little more, look for some sort of a clue, a little bit of red, right in our entry zone, which would be the 382 to 618 fib area, with a stop, you know, not too far above here, possibly even above the high, so at about 55, 56, something like that. So, you know, assuming you got in somewhere in the middle here, if it ends up, you know, going to that point, you're looking at about a 20 to 25 pip risk. And your target is at least the 4,800 area. I'm sorry, the 4,400 area at bare minimum, if not the daily M1 pivot point, which would be the first really area of resistance around 43.90 or 80 or something like that, if not much further, if this is a bigger break. So with that in mind, this 1-minute chart, you're just waiting to see a little bit of red. There's red here, but we're not at the fib zone. Okay, we get up to about 41, I think it was. It was 41, wasn't it? 42, 41? Yeah, 41. Yeah, you have a little wick there. Yeah, that's a very aggressive approach, but the moment you see any hesitation or red, that's what we're talking about. So that's, you know, the type of area you would want to, you know, use as your entry criteria on a fib entry. Stop, you know, normally I would say above the 786, but you have to add spread to this anyway, so you're probably better off just going right above the high here. But anyway, you look at it, 55 to 60, somewhere in there, so we'll just pop it right there at, say, 57, was a decent setup. And now you're looking, you know, exactly at a 22 pip risk, and hands off. And you're just waiting to see if you're right or not. Okay, and within a few candles, you find yourself down at 44.10, and that's about 30 pips profit at that point. Really, at that point, no reason you can't take that stop and move it just to break even. There's no point of risking this at anymore, because you're playing a much bigger trade, and why let 30 pips turn to a negative situation? So a locking and break even here was a reasonable thing to do. And if I go over, back this out a little bit, and then go forward. Okay, I didn't quite want to go that far. You can see what it does. It just does another lower high, lower low, lower high, lower low. And this is the end result, 15 minute. This is the entry zone that we took after the break, the fib retest. Later on, it provided another opportunity to reload in another fib and within another fib. And now we find ourselves just minutes here from the British rate announcement. If I update all these 4-hour and 2-hour charts, you can see that we've come down and broken through the S2 pivot point, and pound is finding itself testing the 5800 at the same time. So, you know, we find ourselves in an interesting trade, a nice little fib entry in there, and it's just been a ride all night type of situation. Hope you guys got a part of that. If you'd like to learn how to do these sorts of trades on a regular basis on your own, please come visit us at fxbootcamp.com. Cheers.